¿Qué hubo, fieras? Espero que estén bien. So, as I mentioned in the post in Instagram, there's a new moon this week. Y esta luna nueva, like all the other new moons, is bringing new energy, fresh energy. Y esta energía is usually seen as energy que nos va a ayudar a empezar algo nuevo. Pero en esta ocasión, this new moon is bringing us energy that it is new and it is fresh, pero que nos va a ayudar a terminar ciclos que we've been fighting with for a long time already, okay? Para cada uno de ustedes, the situation is different, so take it as you may. Pero whatever cycle it is that you need to end, it's important que sepan que this could be a cycle that is very deep-rooted within you. It could be something generational, something that you've been fighting with your whole life, as far as you can remember. And so it is important to take it easy in this time, okay? Tal vez muchos de ustedes están sintiendo frustraciones, enojos. Maybe you're lashing out at people. Maybe you're feeling sad. You don't even know why. And this kind of cycles will do that to you, okay? They're going to put up a fight because these are energies that are used to being around you, that have been around you for a long time. So today, los dioses de Aztlán came through and Quetzal is here to tell us that en este tiempo es super importante that we follow and listen and observe. And Quetzal is here to remind us of the importance of really looking for the signs and really accepting them as they come through from the ancestors. Porque muchas veces we start seeing signs everywhere and we start questioning whether it's something real, whether we're making it up. Y los antepasados want you to know que esto sí es real. Todas las señales que nos mandan, they're for a reason. And mientras más te pongas a ver esas señales, más van a salir. And that just tells you that you are on the right path, that those signs are really there to guide you. Okay, into your next steps, into your healing. So, ya he hablado de esto en otros mensajes, en otros videos, and I said que this year 2020, with all the shit that's going on, it's really part of the healing that we have to do as humanity in our world. And it's been really tough, okay? And I think everybody that's done the work in healing saben que en la sanación es algo muy difícil because you really have to face your demons, you really have to face todos esos miedos que han estado en ti, como dije, por mucho tiempo, por generaciones, okay? So it is really a brave thing that you're doing, trying to tackle these, and I totally believe in you. Los antepasados, los dioses de Aztlán, believe in you, and that's why we're here to have this conversation about that, okay? So el mensaje que nos tienen los dioses de Aztlán today is that whatever this issue is, you know, it could be issues that you have with family members, with people that you love. Ahorita that's coming through a lot because remember that relationships, las relaciones que tenemos con otras personas are super important in our journeys. Cómo nos tratamos a nosotros mismos y cómo nos tratamos a ellos. Remember sometimes when we lash out, we're not even angry at anyone except ourselves. And so that's something that you also gotta forgive. Es parte de la sanación, el perdón que tienes a otros, que tienes hacia ti mismo. It's really important, okay? So whatever this is, it could be addictions, it could be bad habits, como les dije, relaciones con otras personas, con familias, con sus padres, con sus hijos, you know, things that are really close to your heart, whatever situation that is what this is talking about, and I know that en cuanto empiecen a escuchar este mensaje, you'll know. Because esa situación is going to keep coming back to your mind. Okay? And this can be for many different situations. Take it as it resonates to you. So, aquí el mensaje, first of all, is telling us that we got to let this go. We got to move away from it. But we got to move away from it con verdad. You know, not like ignoring it. Not acting like it doesn't matter to us. Pero sabiendo how it affects us, sabiendo what it means to us, what it does to us, and how it makes us react. Okay, so we gotta move away from it. And para muchos de ustedes, it's really hard to see a way forward in this situation. And the ancestors are telling you that the reason why it's hard for you to see a way forward, it's because there is no way forward with things como están ahorita. Okay? They have got to end. They've got to change. And even though you're nervous about it, you're anxious, you're feeling a lot of fear and confusion, know that there's a way. You know, there's a way for you to heal these things that are really bothering you, that are really hurting you, and that are preventing you from living your best life, okay? And here we got three cards that are three fives. Each one is a five. And para mí, número cinco is about changes, okay? It's about changes, and it's about good changes, okay? It's about things that are changing to make way for other things. It's like you rearranging your life, your energies, so that new things can come in and fit in, okay? So know that this is the right thing. Whatever is happening, it's meant to happen. Even if you don't know why, even though you're feeling down about it, tal vez te sientas torcido right now, you know, not knowing how you're gonna get out of it, you know, how you're gonna survive it, really. Know that it's meant to happen this way. And the ancestors are here to tell you that you're not alone. Acuérdense que los antepasados, los dioses de Aztlán, they're always with you. And I know it sounds, sometimes it sounds like a little bit too comic-y, you know, when you say, like, when you feel wind in your face, you know, when you feel the sun that's thrown at you, the moon that's coming through. It's nuestra diosa Coyolxauhqui, nuestra diosa Ixchel. So, you know, it is important for you to understand que the gods are energies that live all around us. They are energies in the universe. And soon I'm going to put up a video about it to tell you more a little bit about how, como es que yo veo a los dioses de Aztlán and how I connect with them. Pero para mí, ellos son las energías que viven a nuestro alrededor. So when you are walking by and you're feeling like you can't even fucking breathe, and de repente sientes un airecito fresco that comes at you, know that that's Quetzalcoatl coming through, you know, caressing you, letting you know that you're not alone, okay? So those are the things that I would really encourage you to pay attention to, because it's happened to me when I'm just here, like, not knowing ni qué onda, you know, like, sintiéndome, like, confused, like, down for no reason, y me acuesto en el zacate. And all of a sudden, the sun shines a little bit brighter. Y ya sé, you know, that it's the ancestors, not at you, coming and giving me light, giving me guidance. And so it's important for us to take every moment y acordarnos de lo valioso que es. Every moment is precious, okay? Aunque en estos tiempos, right now, everything that's going on, especialmente en esta energía de cerrar ciclos que ya hemos traído con nosotros por mucho tiempo, it's really hard, pero acuérdense que es necesario para sanar, okay? Es necesario para dejar de sentirnos como que nos ahogamos porque no sabemos ni qué está pasando, ni por qué estamos sintiendo las cosas, ni por qué reaccionamos o la gente reacciona de alguna manera con nosotros. And that's why, okay? Because there's energy that is stuck y se tiene que ir. It has to disperse, it has to disappear. Okay, but it can't do that unless you heal it. The ancestors are also telling us que muchos de ustedes ya como que se sienten like there's part of you that ya no creen, you know, that que ya no creen que algo va a cambiar, que las cosas se van a hacer un poquito mejor, because you really feel como que you're at the bottom, you know what I mean? And so the ancestors are telling you that healing is coming. It's coming and it's going to get to you. Acuérdense que todo está en el tiempo que tiene que estar. Nada pasa muy pronto ni muy tarde. Cuando pase, it's because it was meant to happen en ese momento. Okay? Y sí, y para muchos se tarda un poquito más, because you are healing things that are even deeper within you. Deeper energies, you know what I mean? Cosas que, como dije, cosas que tal vez sus padres y sus abuelos y tal vez antepasados that you don't even know about have tried to heal through years and years, okay? So don't be hard on yourself if you really feel this is hard, because it is hard. Y eso ahorita es muy importante que cuando sientan estas energías y se sientan como enojados, like you're about to lash out, when you feel like you're about to go off on someone, it's important que you bring it back, okay? You have to have control over this. And that's because acuérdense que cuando uno se siente frustrado y enojado, esa combinación, it's lethal. You know, you can say things that you may never come back from. You know what I mean? Because las palabras que digamos ahora tal vez sean muy fuertes, porque es esa frustración. It's not that you wanna say it, you know? Some people say, oh, you know, when you're angry, this is lo que siempre querías decir. That's not always true. At least I don't believe it is. A veces cuando estamos enojados o frustrados, queremos decir algo para que a huevo la otra persona se sienta mal. You know what I mean? Like, it's not even that we later on want them to feel bad. It's just that at that moment, you know, we wanna cut deep. And that's what we don't wanna do, okay? We don't want to say those words que van a herir a alguien, porque después ustedes son los únicos que se van a sentir mal. You know, because you later on, ya que se les baje el coraje, se van a dar cuenta que you didn't even want to say that. You know, you didn't even mean it. You know what I mean? So be careful con lo que digan ahorita, cuando estén frustrados o estén enojados. Instead of just going off on someone and lashing out, work it out within yourself, okay? And you're gonna need to give yourself a lot of love to do that. So, cuando estén enojados, que sienten que ya ahorita se la voy a rayar, and I'm gonna say this and that, just work it out within yourself first and truly ask yourself, ¿por qué me estoy sintiendo así? ¿Por qué estoy tan enojado? You know, so that's really gonna help you. And so, the ancestors también nos dicen que todo esto está pasando because, one, we are testing the self-love que hemos estado practicando, okay? A veces we feel like, oh, we got this taken care of, I got it down, because it's not happening right now. But when you're faced with those issues again, that's the test that you have to go through and hopefully pass. Okay? So, quiéranse mucho, take care of yourself a lot, take care of your loved ones a lot too. And acuérdense que este ciclo es algo que se tiene que acabar, algo que se tiene que morir, so that something beautiful can come from it. Aquí tenemos a esta carta que me gusta mucho, si la pueden ver. Es Cipactli. En si conocen la historia de Cipactli, luego voy a poner un Instagram o tal vez haga un video de más historias. Pero Cipactli era un monstruo que tuvo que morir para que su cuerpo se hiciera la tierra y el cielo. ¿Me entienden? Así es que that is how we need to look at it right now. Lo que está pasando, el ciclo que estamos ahorita tratando de acabar, es un ciclo que se tiene que acabar para que something beautiful can sprout from it. Okay? And it's really gonna be beautiful. It's really gonna be something that you're gonna feel like fresh air going and filling up your lungs. It's like como si no hubieran podido respirar por mucho, mucho tiempo, así bien, you know, like you haven't been able to take a good breath of air. Y cuando se acabe ese ciclo, you're gonna feel that release. You're gonna feel that nourishment, that new life adentro de ustedes. And that's what needs to happen. So don't fight it. Don't fight the pain, don't fight the anger, but control it. Okay? Rein it in. And always sit in your power, because this is a moment of growth. Bueno, fieras, this is the message. I hope that you like it. Esta luna, it's bringing us that energy. So hopefully, ahora que ya tienen that awareness, puedan saber controlarla y usarla a su ventaja. ¿Ok? All right, fieras. Espero que les haya gustado. I hope that you're doing good. And as always, sending you Fiera vibes. Gracias.